Well, guys, I have a five-game NBA slate for Thursday. First game, Utah and Atlanta. Atlanta going to be on a back-to-back, so we have to watch if they're going to rest anyone. For the Utah side, this is going to be a very good matchup. We've seen a lot of teams be able to just have a lot of good performances against the Hawks because they play fast. Defense isn't that great right now. So, Utah, I'm going to like Donovan Mitchell a lot, 7,800. I think that's a little bit too cheap for this matchup. This is a price where we've seen him play against much tougher opponents. He's still this price, so I do think we're probably getting a slight discount and just paying up for more. He's not really that expensive, but more of these spend up guys, it's going to be more important for a five game slate. So I do like Mitchell a good bit. I prefer him over Gobert, but Gobert, he's fine in his own right because Derek Favors being back, it's cutting into Gobert's minutes. Like when Favors was out, Gobert was getting like 37 minutes, so it was just a lot better scenario for him. And Capella, he's a tough guy. That's going to be rebounding that they're just going to have to battle. So it's not as easy of a matchup for Gobert. Conley, he's fine, 6,600. Trae Young, just never a good defender. He's getting his minutes stacked with Mitchell. So I do like Conley. I think his price is very fair. Other guys, not so much interest. I think you can play Favors for value because it's only five games. So there's a way that he could get there, but just nothing really down there. Atlanta. Trae Young, he has monster upside every game, so I don't want to ever full fade him, especially when he's 9,300. I do think he's a little cheap, and considering that they are without some other guys right now, I think Trae's still very much in play. Capella, he's fine. They're gonna need him out there. He got into foul trouble today, so that's why he only played around 30 minutes. So we should expect him to pretty much, maybe even match Rudy Gobert's minutes. So I think the matchup being tough, it can be just overridden by the minutes that he could see, increased minutes. And Collins, I'm just not going to play him when Capella's healthy. I know he did well today, but this matchup, again, just Utah, they play pretty slow. Defense is solid. And then Herter, I don't want to chase it because Trae Young, when he's in, Herter's ball handling, like he got 10 assists, but that's just not going to happen again. Yeah, no, our minutes still limited. Cam Reddish, 4,700. I prefer to take a shot on Cam than Herter just because you're saving money and really production wise. They're fine. Like they're both gonna start. They're gonna probably play heavy minutes. So, yeah, just no core plays. Golden State side, they're gonna be without Wiseman, Looney. So probably gonna start Juan Toscano-Anderson. He's not any good. I think a lot of people are gonna go into this play. And if he starts, yeah, like I'll definitely have him because he's 3,500, very cheap. But I think we're probably gonna have better value, especially with Dallas if Porzingis does rest on a back-to-back. And like Toscano's minutes, it's just not secure. Even if he starts, we could see them just play small with Draymond at the center. They could use Pascal or Pascal, and they could use Lee, Bazemore, just someone off the bench to fill up the minutes and just slide everyone down. With everyone else, Curry 9,800, I'll never like say don't play Curry. He's just got monster upside every time. Wiggins, Oubre, for Oubre minutes just still being staggered with the other starters. So I like Cam 5,400, just much cheaper than Wiggins. Draymond looks really good because if they are going to play a lot more small ball, Draymond's going to be at center, more rebounding opportunities, a lot more probably open looks, pick and pops, and 5,200 for probably increased minutes here. I am interested because I think they can definitely get away playing that center. No Porzingis probably would mean Draymond actually gets a lot of center just because he's going to be matched up against like Kleber, more small ball lineups and offensive players for centers that don't have any offensive game. And then Dallas side, if Porzingis rests, then yeah, Luka's gonna be a core spend up, Hardaway, he's gonna look good, Richardson as well. But I think I'm gonna be focused on Kleber and DFS. DFS got in foul trouble, so he didn't even play that many minutes. I would think that he should be able to get like 35 if this is a close game. Kleber, he's gonna look excellent as well. He played 32, so we know that the minutes are finally trending a lot, just back up. So I really do think Kleber is a way better value play if Porzingis is out than Toscano-Anderson. For Portland, Dame Lillard, very important injury that we have to watch. If he's in, yeah, I'm gonna have exposure to him. If he's out, then this is just there's gonna be a lot of blowout risk. Maybe Embiid sits because Philly's on a back-to-back, but just can't really say anything too much. I do think though Rodney Hood, regardless of Lillard's status, is gonna look really good because they're still gonna be in that without Nassir Little. Derek Jones is questionable though, so just all these forwards, they're kind of cheap. So I think that one of these guys is going to have a good game. Simons, his minutes were limited last time because of a hamstring injury. He's not on the injury report, so I think He should be able to get another minutes. He's also blowout proof. But the Blazers, you know, tweeted this, said that they've done this thing where they don't say anything about injuries. Like Rodney Hood, he never played any minutes, and he was just a late scratch because he got hurt in practice, actually, in warm-up. So we just don't know sometimes with the Blazers. So I would hope that Simons, because he's not on the report, that he's totally fine, he's good to go. But you know, just something to kind of, you know, be careful with. And then for the Philly side, if Embiid rests, then yeah, we're gonna have to look to Ben Simmons, Tobias as court plays. Portland's just a tremendous matchup for anybody. Seth Curry, you know, just he's not doing it right now, but in good games and high-paced games and you know, the scoring, Seth Curry, he's someone that just has upside because he can knock down a lot of threes. He just get hot quickly, so 4,600, very much in play. Dwight Howard, Tony Bradley, going to be value then if Embiid's going to be out. And then Shake Milton also a mention because he does benefit in blowouts, and also when Embiid's out, when he rests, he does pick up more usage because of the way that they stagger the starting minutes. Houston side, Oladipo, unlikely to play today, so John Wall should be back for this one. He's going to be a court play. He would have played 30 minutes, and now just more rest for him. I can definitely see him play like more than 32. So against Memphis, a team that does play fast, defense, nothing to be scared about. Without Oladipo, John Wall's just going to have a lot more usage. And when he was limited to under 30 minutes, he was still doing really well. So now you take out Oladipo, he's going to play more minutes than this. He can definitely get over 40 DraftKings points, so he's way too cheap in a great matchup. So I love John Wall today. And then Eric Gordon, he's still in play, but he's just still very shot dependent. But just someone that can get there from shooting alone. So I think he's still very much in play. And just for the forwards, like, they're not really core plays. Like, I can definitely see one of them getting into becoming a very good value play. But, you know, there's just so many of them. I don't want to pick that. Like, for tournaments, sure. Now, Memphis side, John Morant's my favorite play, but all of them, they just aren't getting the minutes. Like, I would say Morant in a close game, he should be able to get at least 30 minutes, maybe 32, but they're splitting minutes with everyone. Like, they're just playing everyone like 20 to 24 minutes pretty much, and it's just not good. Like, it's really hard to play any of them in cash. That makes some good tournament plays because, you know, like Dylan Brooks, he can get hot and he can earn a little bit more minutes, but with everyone, it's just tough, especially with the value that we look to with Tillman, Melton. They're all just priced up now. So Memphis, not really a team I can target right now. And then last game, late night hammer, Denver at LA. Jokic, he looks fine on MK. He's just a stud. So always going to be in play. But I'm going to prefer other guys like Luka and Lillard if he's in. So it's going to be tough to go to Jokic probably. I prefer to go to Murray because you're just saving a lot of money. And Murray's the second guy in line for the Nuggets. And we can definitely see AD Gasol play some good defense on Jokic. Maybe that helps out Murray. Also, Gary Harris is out, so there's probably going to be more minutes that are available for these guards. They signed Monte Morris, so I think it's worth a value play. And then Jermichael Green, Paul Millsap. Millsap is cheap, but I slightly prefer Green over Millsap because they're priced pretty closely. And Green is averaging close to 0.2 more fantasy points than Millsap per minute. And they're pretty much playing the exact same minutes. They're pretty much splitting 4 minutes. Jermichael Green's even playing some five. So when Green is the more productive player, I would prefer him for only $200 more. So that's for Denver. Now for the Lakers side, LeBron 80 are probable. And on a five-game slate, again, short slates, you gotta prioritize raw points. So I'm going to prefer LeBron and AD a lot more than I usually do. And Denver, they're good enough to keep this game close. So we can definitely see LeBron and AD have to play some big minutes. And in that case, they should look pretty good. But LeBron, AD, they're both just guys that they don't really have the same 70-point ceiling. Like I think LeBron's hit that maybe once this year. So I just think Luka, Jokic, they have higher ceilings. Maybe not in this matchup for Jokic, but you know, if Luka's without Porzingis, again, just I prefer that play. But LeBron, AD, they definitely are going to be in play because I think you probably get two studs. You usually can, maybe even three if there is a lot of value for this slate. And other people, other players, Schroeder, I think it's totally fine. Harrell, it's going to be tough to get to him because, like, Embiid, that matchup, obviously this is different. But they really didn't allow Harrell to get out on the court because he's undersized. He can't really defend that well. So I think Harrell, it's a little concerning for him. Value, Gasol probably gets more minutes, but he's just very low usage. And KCP, he doesn't play a lot of minutes, but he is 3,500. So for a short game, I think you look to him. So for the value, I think the best play right now is going to be John Wall. And then you can look for Donovan Mitchell as the shooting guard early game play. And I think Ronnie Hund presents some very good value. And then Maxi Kleber from this game, if Porzingis is out. If he's in, I'll update this play, but I'm gonna put in Maxi, and then the spend up is going to be Luka. So that's gonna be the core five right now. If anything changes, which probably there will be because there's a lot of teams on the back to back, I'll make sure to update you guys on my Twitter at Balfour's link in the description below. You can also ask me anything on there, DM me, or if you don't have a Twitter, you can also just comment down below on the video. So I'll make sure to update you guys once again, and thank you guys for watching. Please leave a like before you go, and I will see you in the next video. Good luck, and bye.